In this video, I'm gonna show you the exact location where to find the treasure map signpost in Paradise Palms and the treasure itself. So make sure to leave a like and subscribe, and let's go. Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to another Fortnite video. Today, we're gonna be doing the challenges for week 8, which unlock in 4 hours. But as always, we have them leaked right now. So I'm gonna show you the challenges and locations in just a little bit. But before that, make sure to be using support the creator code NotBoryo40 if you find these videos helpful on the item shop. As you can see, we're getting Easter skins now. This skin is actually super crazy for just 800 V-Bucks. All you gotta do is go to the item shop, go in the bottom right, hit support the creator, write NotBoryo40, hit accept. And once you do it, it would say creator supported, NotBoryo40. But yeah, guys, let's go to the challenges. Alright, guys, so in this video, I'm gonna have the location for search the treasure map signpost found in Paradise Palms. And also search the X on the treasure map signpost in Paradise Palms, which is the first free challenge for week 8. Also, once the challenge is released, I'll have a video on every single challenge. But let's go and do the first challenge. Alright, guys, so for the first stage of this challenge, you actually do have to go to Paradise Palms. So the first stage is actually located right behind this building over here. So it's the second building in Paradise Palms. And once you drop down here, you can see this would be the map signpost that you gotta find. And once the update drops, you would be able to search for this map post or search the map post. And there would be a map on it showing where you gotta go. But we know where to go for stage 2 right now. So step 1 was super simple. You just gotta go right over here on your minimap behind the second building and find this map post. But yeah, guys, you also cannot destroy this map signpost. So don't worry, it's gonna be here no matter if people try to destroy it or not. But anyways, I'm gonna show you the location for search the X on the treasure map right now. Alright, guys, so somebody has already leaked the map image, so we know where the exact location of the new battle star would be, and it's actually located towards Frosty Flights, and it's a really easy spot to find. So I'm gonna show you the spot, and again, the battle star will not pop up because the challenges are not yet released. But as soon as you step over here, you should be seeing the star pop up of the ground. But yeah, the image does show up the entire Frosty Flights plane path with an X towards the end of the map. So basically, right over here, there should be the star. If you guys cannot find it, or if it's a little bit to the side, make sure you're dropping around this area, and somebody would be around this area looking for the star for sure, so you would be able to find it that way. But yeah, guys, once you find the star, that would be stage 2 of the challenge completed, and we're done with this challenge. But yeah, guys, that was the location for search the treasure map signpost found in Paradise Palms, and search the X on the treasure map signpost in Paradise Palms. I'm gonna have a detailed video for every single challenge that's gonna come out soon. But anyways, guys, that's it for this video. If you haven't caught up with the challenges and you haven't done all of your challenges just like me, I'm missing a little bit of the challenges, make sure to watch until the end, because I'm gonna show you some locations from week 7 and you can go and complete the challenges. Thank you so much, guys, for watching, and I'll see you next time. Alright, guys, in this video, I'm gonna show you how to deal damage to people while riding a zipline, the best locations for at Loot Lake, how to deal pickaxe damage to opponents, and the easiest way to do damage to opponents from above. Make sure to leave a like and subscribe, and let's go! Hey, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to another Fortnite video. Today, this video will be my full tutorial for the challenges this week, which are week 7 and unlock in 2 hours. But before we go to the challenges, let's check out the item shop real quick. If you find these videos helpful, do use code NotBoryo40. We got a new pickaxe, which is the banana pickaxe. That one is kind of hot. But anyways, if you do use code NotBoryo40, hit support the creator, write in NotBoryo40, hit accept, and that way you support me. Anyways, let's go back to the challenges. We have the challenges for week 7 leaked, and I'm gonna show you the best and fastest ways to do these challenges, so make sure to hit the like button and let's go. Challenge number 1 is deal damage with pickaxe to opponents, and there is a specific location where it's really easy to do that, and I'm gonna show it to you right now. Alright, guys, it's challenge number 1, and it is to deal damage with a pickaxe to opponents, and there is one simple location that is making it super easy, or it's the easiest location. You still do need to get lucky in order to get it, but in case you're struggling with deal damage with a pickaxe to opponents, the best place is Tilted Towers. And there is one specific spot that is actually that clock tower, but we might not be able to reach it. There is always people going on it. Okay, as you can see, we're about to get some damage. Okay, so he's dancing for no reason, and we're getting our pickaxe damage. We got 3 hits in, 4 hits, 5 hits in. So basically, we got 100 damage, and this clock tower always works. I've done it so many times. Last season, I showed you guys the clock tower. I think for 2 seasons now, I've been showing you the clock tower. But as you can see, first game of the day, it actually worked out. Challenge number 2 this week is visit Junk Junction and the block in a single match. Also Pleasant Park and Dusty Devil, and Happy Hamlet and Snobby Shores. Have 3 stages on this challenge this week. And this challenge is super simple. You just gotta visit the set 2 locations in a single match. Alright guys, the next challenge I did in a separate video, so I'm gonna have it in the end of this video in case you guys have missed my other video, but it's visit pirate camps in a single match. Battle pass challenges. First off, we have deal damage to players from above. Alright guys, so another challenge is to do damage to opponents from above, and this challenge is actually not too hard because you can do it combined with the pickaxe challenge. Once you're in Tilted Towers, that's actually one of the best places to do damage to opponents from above. And basically, you can go to any building you'd like and just scout out for opponents. For example, we see an opponent right in that building. Another really good way to do this challenge is to dig a hole in the ceiling of a house where people go to loot. And literally just wait. As you can see, that's 100 damage right there. I mean, I'm still above if I stay here, so I could count for this guy. Maybe get the shotgun, because the shotgun's much better. Maybe jump would still count as above them. So I'll just jump. And oh, he's trying to do the challenge too. Nope. Okay, well, there we go. That's 200 damage. Probably from above. I honestly think this should count towards the challenge. But yeah guys, another way to do it is to grab balloons, because the balloons let you fly above everyone else. And as you can see, we're gonna try and get this guy that's over here. It is a... Okay. I mean, I was gonna say it is a long shot to get them, but you get the point. That's how to do damage from above to opponents. Next up, we have search chests at Loot Lake or Snobby Shores. And I'm gonna show you the best locations for chests at Loot Lake. Alright guys, for the next challenge, we gotta search for chests at Loot Lake or Snobby Shores. And Loot Lake is definitely gonna be much easier, because currently we have the dig site, and this dig site is still located towards the Loot Lake area, so you can just drop to the dig site and grab a few free chests. That's chest number one. You can inspect the door, which actually is kind of slidey and nice. You can also get another chest right here. Of course, we're going straight into the Loot Lake location. There is one chest right here in this rock. It's a really simple spot, and it glows, so you can see it from distance. And there is, of course, a lot of chests in the middle and around this entire area. So basically, what you gotta do is get over here. These are all possible spawns, so all of these might spawn in your game. I think the ones in the middle used to always spawn, so this is probably your safest bet. And it's the easiest to get 3 chests at the same location. But as you can see, this challenge shouldn't be too hard. It might take you 1 or 2 games, but you should be able to collect at least a few chests per game, because as you can see, they're spread around everywhere at the Loot Lake location. You can also use these tires to get around faster, and if you get the glider redeployed, it's even faster. And just keep in mind, there is also chests in these little boats over there, which still counts as chests at Loot Lake. Okay, next up, we have deal damage to opposing players while riding a zipline for stage 1 out of 2, and deal damage to opposing players who are riding a zipline stage 2 out of 2. Alright guys, the best location to deal damage to people while riding a zipline is actually located near Frosty Flights and Polar Peak. So basically, what you gotta do is drop exactly at this location in between the two, grab this chest real quick. And it is a little bit the luck of the draw, because if you get a bad weapon, it might be really hard to do damage to anyone with it. But anyways, first challenge would be to ride a zipline and deal damage. A lot of people drop over here to Frosty, and you could do damage to those people. Also, once you stop riding this zipline, you can instantly grab to the other one and keep trying to shoot at somebody and get the damage. Another one is down here. As you can see, these ziplines are super connected to the buildings, so there is always people dropping on this tower, and you can just keep riding the zipline. You can even stop me there and just shoot. As you can see, your weapon is pretty accurate, so it shouldn't be too hard to get damage to opponents with a zipline. Another good tip is that you can use the clingers, the sticky bombs and grenades to do damage as well as the dynamite. So dynamiting this house might actually get you some damage, really simple. And that might be the easiest way to deal damage while riding a zipline. Stage 2 of this challenge is to deal damage to opponents who are riding the zipline. And there is no simple particular way to get opponents to go to the ziplines. But if you're just around here and they see you riding it, there is a high chance that they would be riding the zipline as well. Overall, around this area, everyone is using the ziplines because that's where they were introduced. So you can just wait over here, try to hit some people that are riding the ziplines. Okay, last challenge this week is eliminate opponents in different named locations. This challenge you will just complete by playing the game, by eliminating opponents at 3 different named locations. It doesn't have to be in a single match, so this challenge is super easy. Alright guys, and now let's show you visit pirate camps in a single match, 0 out of 3. Let's roll the clip right now. First off, first step would be to go to this pirate camp over here. As you can see, it's located near Dusty Devil, and it's not too hard to find. and you can loot it, you can go your own way. But the best thing about this pirate camp is that down here, right in the basement, there is a vehicle spawn. So you can get this quad crusher. Once you get your quad crusher, you can go to the second location. And the closest location is this pirate camp over here next to the volcano. So as you can probably tell, guys, this challenge is not one of the easy ones, because getting to 3 pirate camps in a single match could be a little bit difficult, because there is a lot of pirate camps that are scattered around the map. There is no 3 locations that are close to each other. But here is a helpful tip. Make sure to use these new volcano shafts and the quad crusher in order to go to the pirate camp as fast as possible. And yeah, guys, as you can probably tell, if you can find the baller vehicle, it would be much easier, because with the quad crusher, it is a little bit difficult. But anyways, we have arrived to location number 2. And this challenge, not gonna lie, is one of the harder challenges. But over here is location number 2 next to the volcano. And in case you do not want to use any more of the quad crusher, you can enter the cannon and send yourself flying to the 3rd location, which is right over there next to Lazy Lagoon. Now, we're not gonna get too close, but this is still viable, so let's go. Fire away!